Hi everyone! Recently, Creality, a company you know very well for making 3D printers, reached out to me to test their new Falcon 2 laser engraver. And, I mean, who doesn't like lasers, right? So today's video is going to be a review. We are going to test what this machine is really capable of, and we'll also try to laser as many things as possible. So without further ado, let's start with the unboxing. Okay, so the whole machine comes to us mostly pre-assembled in one large box. Once we open it, the first thing we see are those paper manuals and some stickers. Creality also sent us samples of different materials like plywood, felt and steel to test our machine on. And they will definitely come in handy. The engraver itself is tightly covered in protective foam, so let's take it out. On the bottom of the package we can find a metal honeycomb workbench, which is very useful for laser cutting. However, it's not included in the stock version, so you will have to purchase it separately. Up next we have our stylish laser protective glasses. And by their side lies the most important component, the 22 watts laser module. Now, I'm gonna be honest with you, this will be my first time using a laser plotter, but I've seen similar devices in the past and they mostly used 5 watts lasers. But this thing basically combines 4 such lasers into one unit. And as a wise man once said, with great power comes great responsibility. So Creality included number of safety features like fire alarm, dirty lens warning and front red glass to protect your eyes. The module itself feels really solid and it's also plug and play, so that's a big plus. Moving on, alongside the laser we can find 24 volts power supply together with power cable. Next we got this plastic box with tiny parts like screws, Allen wrenches and keys to our machine. Another important component is the air assist unit. This part is basically just an air pump which blows high pressure air under the laser. Creality says it helps to remove the smoke and thus makes the cuts cleaner, which makes sense. Additionally, we also have 4 metal legs with rubber ends to prevent the engraver from moving. And lastly, we have this weird device. Initially, I had no idea what it was, but I educated myself and it turns out to be an attachment for engraving on curved surfaces like bottles. Seems fun, we'll definitely test it later. But first, we have to assemble this machine. I've been dealing with 3D printers that you receive in hundreds of different parts my whole life, so I was pleasantly surprised when I assembled the Falcon in just 5 minutes. You simply need to screw in all the legs, plug in the power connector, attach the laser module and plug in the air tube, then take the air assist unit and connect it to the same tube, lastly plug the power cable to the air unit, and just like that the Falcon 2 is ready to go. Super simple. Now if we switch the power on, nothing happens, and that's because we forgot about our key. Once we turn it, the Falcon finally comes to life. All the LEDs on the laser module light up green, so the machine is fully operational. To check both axes, you can press the home button. And they seem to work fine. This engraver also has one safety feature that all the 3D printers lack, an emergency stop button. Once something bad happens, we can just smash it and the power is immediately cut. Now, to control this engraver, I will be using LightBurn software. First thing we need to do here is to import the Falcon 2 profile from the SD card. Then, in the settings tab, we have to set millimeters per minute. Lastly, we can configure Falcon 2 device settings. And just like that, we are ready to connect. To do this, we can simply use USB-C cable and then choose the right port. Now, to see if everything works, we can import a test picture and click frame. This will make the laser move around the current work area. Just remember to always home before doing that, or the laser might crash into the frame. Luckily, Falcon 2 has collision detection, so it won't cause any damage. And that's a good feature. Before we start engraving, we need to do 2 more things. First, let's take a look at this spreadsheet provided by Creality and change our speed and power settings. Next, we have to adjust the laser height with the help of this thingy. Now, there is nothing else to press except start. This first picture came out really nice. The software did a good job of applying different gradients and the whole process was really quick, but we are just getting started. For the next test, I wanted to try the QR code tool. This also came out really nice, and to test if it really works, go ahead and try scanning it yourself. Next, I wanted to engrave something bigger, so I took this wooden plank and uploaded one of my many blueprints. Now this looks really cool. I could totally hang it on my wall. I wonder what else can we engrave. Here I got my pocket piano, an instrument called kalimba. It's made out of wood, so we can try to engrave something on the back. This one also came out nice. But I think that using higher resolution picture could have improved the quality a bit. Nevertheless, it's a cool drawing. Now let's try something different. Here I got a notebook with the cover made out of something that looks like leather. And I'm gonna try to engrave my logo on it. Okay, this looks really good, although by mistake I set max power level for the text section and before I stopped it, it almost cut out the letter C, but overall it's a good looking cover. At this point I was just throwing random things under the laser, so here is the silicone phone case. The logo turned out okay, but it's not really that visible. The results might be better on brighter colors. Now here is something you probably shouldn't do. My old smartphone has a plastic back, so I decided to try engraving it as well. Well, I don't really know what I expected, but this logo doesn't look good. I probably set the laser power level too high, it kinda melted the plastic and it turned out pretty ugly, so don't do it. So now for the change of pace, let's try something with steel. After all, one of the biggest selling points of this machine is the ability to color metals by heating them up. So I created this material test to see all the spectrum of colors it can produce. And the results are really interesting. As you can see, we do have a wide range of colors, from burnt brown to soft pink. But I think it's possible to get many more colors by experimenting with laser height and power settings. However, during this test, my lens control light turned yellow, which means the glass became dirty. To fix this, we can unscrew the laser cone and use included cloth to wipe the lens clean. If the lens is somehow damaged, you can replace it with the additional one that's in the box. After the procedure, we need to reset the laser and the light becomes green again. For now, I run out of ideas for engraving, but I really want to try cutting something. So, here is the Eagle file that comes with the Falcon on the SD card. For this to work, we need to lower the laser to the second step. We can also increase the air assist power, in order to get rid of the smoke. And the results here are incredibly good. This Eagle model has many tiny cuts and holes, and all of them look perfect. The Falcon 2 did a really good job right here. Okay, but that was just 2mm plywood. How about much thicker OSB board? Here I wanted to make a model of my country. So first I engraved the outlines of every region, and then performed a cut at max power level on the borders. Now this is really impressive. OSB board is a tough material and the laser was able to deal with it with no problem in just one pass. Creality says it can cut up to 15mm and now I totally believe them. It's really cool that a laser, which is basically just a strong light beam, can perform such deep cuts. All the things we have done so far are mostly just for decoration. So can we make something functional? Recently I wanted to buy some insulation gaskets for my Leon cells, but now I think I can make them myself. So I cut those gaskets out of felt sheet with double-sided tape. I probably should have used more laser power since not everything was cut out, but overall they work great, and I just saved some money. And now, at last, we have to try the rotary attachment. Its installation is really easy. First you need to add these special razors to every leg, next connect it to the Y-axis cable, and then just type one command in LightBurn. It's also really important to place the module in the right direction, which I realized after my logo came out mirrored. Later I fixed my error, and the engraved text looked really professional. And for the last test of this review, I just wanted to engrave something stupid. So I got this picture from the internet and let the Falcon do its job. And it turned out way too good for a low quality shitpost picture. Now I'm convinced that this machine can really engrave anything. So, to summarize this whole review, I think it's safe to say that Falcon 2 is a really versatile machine. I know that comparing it to 3D printer is kinda pointless, since those are two different devices, but still I was blown away with how fast the setup was and how easy it is to use Falcon 2 compared to dozens of hours I spent to achieve my first 3D print. Also, its many safety features make it a great machine for new users. However, proper review should also list some negatives. But to be honest, I don't really have any major complaints. Only thing I feel could be improved is to integrate the air assist unit into the frame, because as it is now, it just awkwardly lays at the side. Also, if you are planning to use this machine in a place with bad ventilation, enclosure is a must. Engraving wood by itself isn't that bad. But using this laser on a plastic can create toxic fumes, and cutting, especially if the object is thick, creates clouds of smoke. Just keep that in mind. So, do I recommend the Falcon 2? Yes, I do. It's a great machine that's simple to use, has plenty of cutting power, and can be used in surprisingly many ways. I'm in fact already planning to use it in future projects, especially for making lightweight plane parts from wood and foam. Now, if you want to get this machine and test it by yourself, check out the description for a special promo link. But for now, thank you all for watching. Let me know what you think of Falcon 2 down in the comments. Also, thanks Creality for sending me this device. And, well, see you all soon. Bye!